Most of us have a love-hate relationship with aging. We all want to make it into our senior years, but no one wants to get there to find it's not much fun. The greatest challenge is dementia. It's estimated 400,000 Australians will be diagnosed with dementia in the next 5 years, and that number will more than double in 30 years. So the race is on to try and find better treatments, if not a cure. Can I start by asking how old you are, Harold?
I'm 98 on my last birthday, Christmas Day.
And Lee?
I'm 95.
94.
91. I'll be 92 in October.
And how old do you feel?
129.
Officially, they're known as the oldest old. Men and women over the age of 85. Harold, his wife Lee, Jim and Bea. With a combined age of 378 years, this group is helping to unlock the secrets to living a long life. So now that you're both in your 90s, does anything actually change from the 80s or the 70s?
You do look in the mirror, particularly as a woman, and I stand there and I go like this maybe, and then I go the heck with it.
Do you like being in your 90s?
You have no choice.
Of course.
Well, what's the alternative?
I just don't think of my age. Except once in a while when I have a pain, I go, huh?
Very vain about that chin business.
Dance me to your beauty with a burning violin.
They're part of what's called 90 Plus. One of the world's largest studies aimed at learning as much as possible about longevity and dementia in preparation for a tidal wave of elderly.
Okay, and now turn them like this, like you're going to catch them.
Half of all children born in Australia, the United States, and Western Europe today will live to a birthday past 100.
That is a lot of people.
Half of all children born today. I think that's a staggering thing to think of.
A3. Neurologist Dr. Claudia Kawas is leading the study with a team from California University, UC Irvine.
First of all, I'm trying to find out what lifestyle factors in your 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s are relevant for how you look in your 90s. Because many of us now are doing all kinds of things that we hope promote health and wellness, but we don't really have scientific evidence for some of these things.
Welcome to Laguna Woods Village, California.
So, for the past 5 years, Dr. Kawas has been delving into an extraordinary bank of data provided by residents of Laguna Woods Village in Southern California. It's home for the 55s and over.
Oh,
and 34 years ago, 14,000 residents filled out an extensive survey about their lives.
The questionnaire asked them things about their lifestyle, their diet, their exercise, whether or not they took vitamin E supplements, whether or not the women took estrogen, and what kinds. They wanted to know things about lifestyle factors of this active community.
Where were you born?
Manhattan, New York City.
Today, more than 1,600 elderly residents are taking part in Dr. Kawas' study, including 91-year-old B. Gross.
Good. Now please spell world.
W-O-R-L-D.
Yes. Now spell world backwards.
D-L-R-O-W.
B, a mother of three who has an MBA, was married 65 years until her husband died in 2010.
Brown shirt
on. Now, every 6 months, she is tested for mobility and memory.
So I'm going to give you 1 minute, and you'll tell me as many animals as you can.
Dog, cat, squirrel, beaver, badger, cow, mule, donkey.
The results of the study so far are interesting. Alcohol gets a thumbs up.
Alcohol a couple of times a week, and it didn't seem to really matter which kind, although most people were drinking wine with dinner. That was also associated with living longer than never having alcohol.
I do believe in a drink before dinner. 2 p.m, I wouldn't think of taking one. Means nothing at night, but the drink before dinner, I called for my husband attitude readjustment time.
Dieting gets a thumbs down.
Being thin is just not good as you get into your 80s and 90s.
Skinny's out.
Skinny is out.
You're careful with your diet, or do you just eat what you feel like?
Both. We feel like eating the right things.
Well, you don't like chicken, but we have chicken.
I'll keep on. And when it comes to exercise, less, it seems, is more.
Well, actually, even 15 minutes a day on average conferred some advantage in longevity. I think the good news is that 3 hours a day didn't do any better than 45 minutes a day.
Yes.
And I think the other thing, though, is that it didn't have to be all at once.
We need purpose.
Just as important is a mental workout. And for B, that can be completing a jigsaw.
These are the stairways.
You'll see, you'll get hooked on this.
I already am.
Or playing bridge. You're quite competitive, aren't you, B?
Medium, yeah.
You get... That's why I don't play bridge. They are very competitive and
there are
very,
some
very active about it, too.
Lovely people playing. Yeah. There are a few who are not nice.
Oh, very
and
true.
And you just go to the table, keep your mouth shut, and move on.
But you like to win.
Well, now that you mention it. Yes.
For Harold and his wife Lee, their daily chores are enough to keep them on the move. And after 48 years of married life, they believe their relationship is the greatest contributor to their long lives.
And then pull that down there.
I think without her, I wouldn't be here today.
Can I ask you about romance? Is there still romance in your life?
Romance? Well, there are several ways of defining that.
However you choose to.
Yes, it is a romantic relationship. I want my goodnight kiss and I want my good morning kiss. And that's enough.
So I'm going to say and show you three words for you to remember. I want you to repeat them back to me after I've said all three words. Shirt.
Shirt.
Brown. Honesty. Good. Tell me those words.
Honestly, I'm not a brown shirt.
But the study's main focus is understanding Alzheimer's. At 98, Harold has gone through this test 16 times, and every time he passes with flying colors. Researchers want to know why he is dementia-free, while so many like him are not.
At your normal pace, turn around and come back.
I have pledged to donate my brain to the study.
You don't mind handing your brain over, huh?
Well, yeah, I may have holes in my brain, but I don't have Alzheimer's, and if that's the case, that's something they should know.
When Harold and the other participants die, their brains and lives will be closely examined by Dr. Kaywas and her team.
Good morning, everyone.
And it's at these meetings, after the death of participants, that the team has made its greatest discoveries.
Oh, my God, look at her memory scores.
I know. Tell me, do you follow current events?
Oh, very much so.
It's long been believed that in the brain, What's known as plaques and tangles cause cell death and tissue loss, resulting in dementia and Alzheimer's. But the brains donated by the 90-plus participants are telling a very different story.
Traditionally, we thought anybody who had those plaques and tangles, the amyloid, would absolutely be an Alzheimer's sufferer.
That's pretty much the definition of Alzheimer's disease, is to find these plaques and tangles on autopsy. But now, with this new technology, I think we're starting to realize that you can have these changes in your brain, and even for a long time, and maybe not have dementia.
What their research is suggesting is that microstrokes or infarcts might be the true cause of Alzheimer's.
Microinfarcts is a very, very, very small, essentially hole in the brain. And we've always thought that they were just too little to really matter. Now we're understanding that microinfarcts probably contribute to dementia on a level equivalent to Alzheimer's disease.
So if you can find a way to stop those microstrokes, then you're on a completely different path of treatment.
Absolutely.
And Dr. Kaywas is also reassessing the impact of high blood pressure.
Individuals who have it in late life, especially if they develop high blood pressure in their 80s or 90s, appear to be protected from dementia compared to individuals with normal blood pressure.
Dance me to the end of love.
This study could well lead the way to new treatment and even prevention of dementia and Alzheimer's. But those 90-plus participants have some equally important news: that life is to be celebrated no matter your age. It seems to me life is still good.
Life is good, yes. Yes, it is.
I mean, when we were children and we were 50 years of age, you were old. So that's how much the world has changed. Now, the 80 and 90 years of age is pretty normal.
Hello, I'm Liz Hayes. Thanks for watching. To keep up with the latest from 60 Minutes Australia, make sure you subscribe to our channel. You can also download the 9Now app for full episodes and other exclusive 60 Minutes content.